Back to Rush Hour. This is the big issue. My name is Mubarak Mugawi. You can join the conversation on our social media platforms. I beg your pardon. On our social media platforms at Urban TV Uganda on Twitter, Facebook, Urban Television. And of course, you can also join us on my own Twitter handle at Mubarak UG. But also, please download the New Vision digital experience so that you can as well access the app, so that you can access every news and latest from the, you know, all over the world, and of course with local stories. Now, in the big issue today, we want to discuss Kampala's border issues. The government seemed to roll out a plan to restrict to reduce on the number of borders that can access the central business district. This seemed not to have been actually well with the border leaders and also the politicians. But joining us to discuss that are two distinguished guests. In studios, we have Mr. Chiviri Kanyike, the chairman, Border's Central Division. And also joining us live online is Anderson Burora, the RCC of Rubaga Division. A very good morning, gentlemen. And of course, welcome to the big issue. Mr. Kanyike, let me start with the RCC, Mr. Burora. What exactly do you actually make of this plan? And how far is government with these plans?
Good morning, viewers. The plan is not for government alone, but the plan is for Ugandans saving lives and reducing crime, but also making sure that this sector is joined by competent people, because they tend to carry cargo and human beings at the same time. So we need to create order, but also to make sure that there is safety for humans who are being transported by this sector. So what we make of it is to make sure that we put some sort of order and make sure that whoever is using this transport, either as a rider or as a passenger, they are all secure and their lives are in safe hands.
Yes.
Which is not the case today. But also the society is crying. It is facing a lot of challenges, and these challenges, no one is coming out to restrict them. No one is coming up to give a hand to make sure that things get back to order. And this is why this campaign, for heaven's sake, is not about government effort. The biggest outcry is to make sure that the public gives the biggest hand in making sure that this order comes to life.
Anderson, there has been actually very, figures that are not so clear. How many borders do you want to access the CBD within this plan?
Well, that figure has been given, and we are revising it either upward or downward. And that will depend on the compliance. That will depend on how those who are responding are responding. We may need 100, but in the 100, we find out that actually we need 200 or we need 50. That will depend on the analysis we shall make from the training, the analysis we shall make during registration, who are registering. If you read the statistics we have now from those who have turned up, majority of them have health complications. Others are participating in illegal acquisition of these motorcycles. Some are not in the right places. So we realize that we might come up with a decision that is informed by the statistics, by the realities we are picking from this training. So I can't be specific on a number, but I can tell you that the number that is within the city now will reduce drastically. It will reduce a very big numbers.
I will come back to you, Anderson, in a minute. Let me just bring in now Mr. Kanyike. the RSTC is talking about creating sanity in the city, the risks that come with these borders. And of course, the plan looks so beautiful because we need a clean city and a very organized city because also we need to be safe. What exactly, why are you opposed to these beautiful plans? Mr. Kanyike, please.
Okay. Morning, viewers of Urban TV. Those are my names. I'm Kanyike Chivi, the chairman of Boda, Kampala Central Division. We are not really opposing this good program, but we need to do these things in programs, following programs. Like, according to our proposal, we submitted to government officials. We had a proposal starting with mobilization and sensitizing. We need to mobilize our members so that they know what we are going to do in them.
Yeah.
After mobilizing, then there is sensitization, like going on TVs, going on ground, keep on sensitizing what you are going to do in them. After that, we propose that we are going to call out registration, registering all border riders within the city. After that, we come up with the training. Then the training will help us to synchronize who people are willing to join the industry, who are capable of doing the business of border. So even us, we want to change the image of border. But people think that we don't want. The issue of chasing our borders in CDB is really a problem. According to their proposal, the feed zone area is very wide. It's the most populated area. So we can't agree to on that free zone unless we will move some stages according to our program. So when we see in the Kampala Central Division, it's where we have the NMT, non-motorized transport. On that NMT, we had like 60 stages. As per now, those stages are not located anywhere. So when you do your program without consulting the owners or the stakeholders, then it will disturb our people. And the issue of the numbers, as per Central Division, we have like 28,000 in the industry in Central Division. So for them, they want like 5,000 members. So that's a big number of people who are going to lose their jobs. According as per now, we've gone to the training. It's not the right time for go to the training, but we accepted it because it's a government program. We had to move on the program as we submitted, like sensitizing. Then after sensitizing, then we go for the training. Most of the people, they just came in. Or they just get the news of this training. The training came in the period when people don't have money. We were coming from COVID period. Most of the border people, they don't have that money. So we proposed, we gave a proposal to the government so that the government should pay for that.
Government within Zeko, because government in David is Zeko, COVID, Baba, what time?
But what time? We had a proposal that government should pay for the training. Then the government refused to pay for the training. Then this exercise of paying, we need to mobilize slowly by slowly, telling our members whether they can get a small loan from our circles. Tolerant are worried, they just brought the issue of training
before the Anderson from here. Why do you hijack the industry and you don't give them time to organize? Why is the rush, Anderson?
What time are you talking about?
I mean, the border, you have heard him is saying that you were never given time to sensitize the border people. And I'm also of the question that why don't you give them the time that they ask you?
When did you learn of this engagement? Is it yesterday or last month? I'm asking.
No, please, you explain.
I'm trying to say that there has been time. Much has been said. We have participated in the situation. I have personally had about 5 months top of the situation. So you cannot say that there are never given time. And if you want time, you will never be able to, because if you
get signed and we abuse it, it does not mean that corrects whatever they are doing. So I think high time that the same thing is incorporated according to the requirements we have as of now. But I think the 6 months, the limit of what it gave them was that time, which was not their time alone. As people participated, ministers participated, they have been involved in participation. So if you don't understand the limit, they are limited last time. And we have like that. We have not like that. We are just trying to come and participate in what being actually discussed, and that is not possible.
Mr. Kanjike, how much time do you?
Auntie, according to our proposal, we put sensitization time for 2 months. We hope that at this period of 2 months will be sensitizing the mass of the border. Then after that, we call out registration of all border riders. Then this registration will know who is having a driving permit or who doesn't have a driving permit. Then after registration, then you had to go for the training of all border riders. After that, we had to go for gazetting stages. So we need to do these things on program, not just bring the all things together, because as for now we are doing training, at the same time we're doing registration, at the same time we're doing uniforming. Those things, they can't move together. They have to move step by step. That's why we are urging them so that they can at least give us more time, not these 6 months, because if you divide these 6 months in our program, it can't fit in. That's why we propose they give us more time. We don't oppose the training, we need it, because most of them, most of our leaders, they don't have qualification, like 80%. Not that even the government neglected the business or the industry. If it started earlier, it could be better. I think I'm very happy today because most of the government agents, they are now coming together, because we are seeing one voice of the Minister of Works. Then even KCC is saying the same, the technical part of it. But we are also losing the political part of it, because I'm not seeing Rod Mayor there. He's not there. He has spent almost 15 years. He's saying he's going to enact the law of ordinance.
The Lord Mayor is not here to defend himself, but actually I just want to pick your mind before I go back to RCC as we are winding up. Isn't the RCC raising very pertinent issue that actually your industry that you work in has problems to do with crime and of course sex, you know, safety excesses, and also the society needs to move forward and, you know, go beyond these challenges because they have been existing for long? Please.
So I agree with the LRCC that there are a lot of evil things in border, but we need to study things program by program. If at all we do it abruptly, it will cause havoc, because people are saying they don't have money because I'm industry. Even I'm a leader, I know what the situation is. To go on the stage and to get 20,000 is a tug of war. Even you have family, you are renting. They give us more time, like
meaning actually that you know the problems do exist, and the government has a goodwill in ensuring that these problems are addressed. We shall come back to that same point with Anderson, but after taking this short break, we are discussing border regulations in Kampala, and of course this is the big issue. My name is Mubarak Mugabo. Let's take a break. We are returning in a while.